I don't have good boundaries, I'm going to say yes. Because people who are too open with their boundaries, they cannot say no. And so sometimes they end up kind of looking flaky because, you know, they have so much going on, but they can't say no. They overcommit. And then, you know, then our family members end up being mad with us, you know, because they're like, well, why did you say yes if you couldn't do it? Well, the reality is because we do not have the capacity to say no. An individual that has extremely open boundaries gives too much. Yes, we've all been there, and we all have that one friend who gets in relationships and gives their absolute all, everything. And then when that doesn't work out, they're confused, saying, well, what's wrong with me and what's wrong with a person? You know, if I gave too much, I'm expecting that it's going to work out, but it doesn't, because, again, we're establishing unhealthy limits in our relationships by giving too much. Individuals who have open, like extremely open boundaries, get involved too quickly. You know, you meet this person today, next week you move in with them. And, you know, this is nothing to do with morality. We all have our different values, but let's talk about emotional intelligence, okay? You met someone today. Say you're going to marry them in 2 months. Just think of how much time does it take to know a person? You know, sometimes you could be with a person 6 months and you're just getting to the surface of who they are. When you get involved too quickly, you know, hopefully it works out, obviously. You know, we always wish the best for us and our family members. But when you get involved too quickly, you are missing important information that you could have gathered if you dated this person a little longer. You know, perfect example of domestic violence, okay? An aggressor or a perpetrator, somebody that inflicts domestic violence, they like to get involved in their relationships quickly because guess what that gives them? It gives them power and control over the person, right? So, you know, I can control you better if I live with you quickly. And so just a little FYI, always a red flag when somebody wants to get involved too quickly. An individual with extremely open boundaries is very trusting. I think that, you know, at one point in my life, I was a victim of that. You know, I meant well. I thought, like, I always saw the best in the person. I never really thought, like, maybe this person is just playing me for a fool. I didn't have that filter. You know, I assumed that everybody's inherently good. And contrary to popular belief, trust and respect are not freely given. Trust and respect is something that you work to earn during a relationship. Somebody who has extremely open boundaries, they intrude on others. They violate another person's boundaries, because if you don't have limits for yourself, how are you going to have limits for others? It just doesn't work. That equation doesn't work. And another indication of someone that has extremely open boundaries is they stay in relationships too long. So they know this relationship is not healthy. They know this relationship is not really going anywhere and might be hurtful to them, yet because they don't understand, like, part of my emotional responsibility is to keep myself safe by setting a distance from me and this person who is emotionally harming to me. And they don't want to deal with the emotions that are going to come out after leaving a relationship that's unhealthy. So they stay in relationships too long because they expect to deal with their distress by staying with the person. It's like we are looking to cope externally through another person. So in a nutshell, that is a person whose boundaries are too open. Now, let's talk about the complete opposite. Let's talk about people that are too closed off or too distant. How do you know? You know, I probably have more to say about an individual who has extremely open boundaries because I think, I don't want to stereotype, like, just in my experience, I feel like women are usually the ones to be, like, too open with their boundaries. I don't know if it's also like the socialization, that the difference between the socialization in men and women, you know, women are more allowed to feel, women are more allowed to express feelings more than men in our society in general. Now, there are individuals who have, it's the opposite. They are too distant. And how do you identify these individuals? They have difficulty saying yes in relationships. So as opposed to, yes, I'll do this, yes, I'll do this, everything is like, no, I will not do this. They isolate, they are very distrusting, and then they end up feeling lonely because they isolate and they stay in relationships for a short period of time. And I think the reason for that is that when you are in a relationship, it is inevitable that you're going to have to get close, and somebody with close boundaries sometimes is not willing, they don't have the skills to open up, so they would rather sabotage the relationship as opposed to learning healthy ways of opening up and, you know, dealing with whatever comes out. So what are the purpose of emotional boundaries? We establish emotional boundaries to teach people, including our children, our family, our spouse, how to treat us. They keep us safe. And boundary problems are a misdirected attempt at being loved. Yes, ladies, I said it. For those of you who ask yourself, why do they take advantage of me all the time when I give my all to the relationship? Well, that is exactly your answer. When we give our all in a relationship, we think that it's going to teach a person to be, I don't know, maybe grateful to us or maybe indebted because we're good. Well, what we have seen again and again, and not only that, what research supports is that the reason that people give too much is because it's a misdirected attempt at being loved. So it's not so much that we are extremely good people. It's that in reality we're giving our all because we want them to love us, because we're trying to win them over with the things that we do. And so instead of winning them over, we're like, oh, you know, yes, of course, I'll do this for you and I'll do that for you. And then we teach them to exploit us. But not only that, when we are unable to do that for them, they get mad at us because we set an expectation. And so we isolate because we say, oh, well, I gave them my all and they took advantage of me. And then we isolate in an attempt to protect ourselves. But then we're alone again with no support. And so I'm going to give you one brief example of how boundaries keep us physically safe. We go on a date. It's a first date. Say that we have intercourse on the first date. The person has no protection, okay? And they're like, oh, it's okay, you don't know me, but no, I'm not going to give you AIDS, I'm not going to give you herpes. Well, we don't know that. And so a lot of us with unhealthy boundaries are going to be like, oh, well, maybe if, you know, if I say no, he's not going to like me. Well, guess what? Being able to say no at that moment might save us from contracting a virus that will never leave our body. And I know this is kind of drastic, but what I'm trying to tell you is, just like healthy boundaries keep your physical body safe, emotional boundaries protect our emotions from unfair demands. They protect us from abusive relationships, and they protect us from domestic violence, because from the get-go, we are showing this individual that this is the limit that I set. I will be respected. And so we teach people how to treat us, and then they just weed themselves out. They're like, this is somebody that I probably will not be able to exploit, or I will not be able to use my unhealthy dynamics with them. And so in essence, when we set good boundaries with our kids or our couple, we are preventing extremes in relationships. You know, like there's individuals like, oh, well, this didn't work out. So I've actually heard during one of my counseling groups, an individual said, well, since this lady, you know, played with my feelings, I will have one night stands from now on. Or have you heard those individuals that say, oh, well, this person treated me bad, so now I'm going to be a bad person. Well, if we had healthy boundaries from the beginning, we wouldn't need to be in extremes in our relationships. And so I just want to end with this before giving you my contact information. I want to end with, it's important to set boundaries with yourself as well as others. So say no to yourself too, you know, say no, say, Evelyn, stop engaging in that unhealthy behavior, because deprive yourself of too much, you know, whether it be overeating, whether it be like working too hard, whether it be not taking time for yourself or not allowing yourself pleasure, set your own limits. You know, I think this will be the best practice in learning how to interact with others. And so what we have found is people with difficulty setting boundaries violate other people's boundaries as well. And so very important, you know, this is a skill that I believe makes us able to function better at work, function better as a couple, and function better with our kids. It's just, it keeps things in perspective and in place, and it avoids avoidable suffering. So I just want to give you an information on where you can find me. My name is Evelyn Bernal, and you can find me on Facebook and Instagram, last name Bernal, B-E-R-N-A-L. And I have been in the counseling field for the past 16 years. And so through these programs, my objective is to talk about emotional intelligence stuff that first of all, is evidence-based. You know, as a graduate student, as a person in this field, I am held to those standards. Like, I can't just read you something I read off a magazine. This information was actually researched and shown to be something that if we establish in our relationship, it's going to work. If you go to my Instagram page and my Facebook page, again, Evelyn Bernal, you know, send me your inboxes, send me your shout outs, and also send me your questions, and then I will try my best to address them in our other show. Again, this is Evelyn Bernal. Thank you for listening to me, and this is my program, Entre Mujeres. Till next time.